10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Dire team ban. Radiant team ban. Dire team pick. Remaining.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back into the Dota 2 Canada Cup Season 7 Grand Finals. Digital Chaos, as well as Void Boys, going toe-to-toe here in game number 2, the draft now underway. And Purge, we just witnessed a pretty good game number 1. I think a lot of people determined that Void Boys might not be up to the same tier as DC, but I think all things considered, they did very well for themselves in that first game.
Yeah, they did. They won a couple team fights. Their draft had showed some good ideas, and they had good solutions to disruptor opening. We'll see how this game goes. It could go very differently. It seems like Void Boys is reacting slightly to what DC is doing, and that's going to be a little bit tough if DC keeps changing up their style every time, because they could just eke out advantages to practice and playstyle.
Yeah, I mean, it comes down to obviously DC are the more veteran team. And obviously, they've performed better over the past couple of months, and obviously DC are DC. Void Boys, a good solid squad that a lot of, I think, American team or American people that watch these tournaments know all about. I mean, these people are, and Patsil in particular, they're kind of legends in their own right, but Void Boys definitely a team that you look at against them going against the power squad of DC, it's definitely tough for them. They'll pick up the Oracle and Darkseer to start things out, so a vastly different draft from, well, both squads. It's Digital Chaos pick up the Faceless Void for them as they grab that first. Interesting stuff to start things out here, Brood.
Yeah, very weird to see both. I do know that Oracle is generally seen as very strong by a lot of the NA teams. And maybe I shouldn't say NA teams, but maybe like the regional quality level NA teams. Just because the survivability gives, the laning of it is quite strong as well. Darkseer also gives you very good laning. I wouldn't necessarily Oracle's good against Faceless Void though, so that part's a bit weird, but maybe we'll see something special out of the hero. But as of yet, I haven't been ultra impressed with these first round Oracles. It does prevent the Batrider for their opponents, but past that, I'm kind of a little unsure why people are picking it so early.
Yeah, I mean, first two seems strange to me, but I'm sure there's a reasoning behind it that I can't really figure out. But on the other side for DC, they have the Faceless Void, though, and this is like the Faceless Void Phoenix is a very strong combination of two heroes that I wouldn't mind seeing for DC. I don't know if they're going to go down that Phoenix route, but Faceless Void Phoenix was like a 1-2 punch in a lot of those games at the TI qualifiers.
Yeah, it was pretty common. It could definitely happen here. I think it'd be good. Sunray obviously kind of just cuts right through Oracle ulti in a lot of ways. Maybe not cuts through it, but it goes through Fate's Edict as well. They'll go for the Cypher run, go for Elder Titan. When you grab Phoenix, it kind of makes your lanes a little bit weak in some ways, but Elder Titan kind of covers your bases a lot better. It's a little bit harder to counter in a lot of ways. So good opening for DC, and they can pretty much go wherever they want with their draft now.
Yeah, and Elder Titan just, it with the natural, of course, resistance reduction with both magic and armor resistance reduction, it actually helps Faceless Void do more damage, where it doesn't necessarily hit like a wet noodle during the Chronosphere, but it certainly helps his damage out, I think. Of course, because also Time Lock being magical as well certainly helps, but it's going to be the setup with the ET and the Chronosphere with the Stomp, with obviously the Aerosplitter, which is very good. But for now, more bans coming through. This time, no more Terrorblade for DC. Lifesteal are already banned out. And again, they also banned out Snake King's Beastmaster, which is kind of interesting to me. He's been playing that a lot. Snake King, obviously, one of the better Beastmasters in NA. So it's good they get rid of that hero. And some other bans coming out that are rather interesting, as well as the Earth Spirit and the Ricky being taken away by Void Boys.
Yeah, I don't think the first round bans are too weird here. Just Ricky's kind of annoying to play against, and if you're not as good at playing against it, then you're gonna get crushed by it. And that was a hero that people were banning against DC at Manila Majors. So if that's what you fear, that's what you fear. I think it's completely reasonable.
Just take it out of the pool. you don't want to play up against it, then that's fine.
Beastmaster as well. It's something that Void Voice has been playing a lot. And they could AFK jungle it due to having offlane Darkseer, and they wouldn't be able to pressure it super well. So I think Beastmaster being out isn't weird at all. A little surprising. Now that I see Bounty, it's like, Bounty made it this far? What the heck?
I mean, it's just that there's so many other bans that teams have to figure out nowadays. And Bounty Hunters feel like it's like, it had its time, and then everyone's just like started forgetting about Bounty Hunter being like a hero. Like everyone started forgetting about like Bounty Hunter being really, really strong as a four position or whatever hero you like to run it in. And they're gonna pick it up for Void Boys. So Bounty Hunter Oracle is the dual support combination for them. And obviously with Darkseer, Bounty Hunter in combination with that hero is pretty strong. But some interesting choices coming through.
Lone Druid is kind of a cool pickup. They may put it mid. Weeha does play it there sometimes. It's semi-survivable against Bounty Hunter, so that may be one of the solutions there. And right now, Void Boys just don't have very good solutions against it at all. They have three heroes that actually don't do very good damage. Bounty, Darkseer, and Oracle are not very effective against a Lone Druid that has like a hood or maybe even a pipe. So Slaughter is going to go a little bit towards helping that out, but those first three pickups for Void Boys are a little non-synergistic. Like, they don't have stuns, they just have magic nukes, weak disable, some slows, but some team fight, but they don't have catch and the ability to kill. So here, like, Faceless Void right now is like really happy.
I was wondering about that.
For him to die this game.
I was like, it feels like the voice is going to be able to survive throughout all of this, because the only disable they have now is Slardar with the Slithering Crush and I guess Shuriken, which is a mini stun, but that's it.
That's not going to be enough. At the very minimum, his laning stage should be really easy. He may take some nukes and stuff, but as long as he doesn't get nuked and then Slardar stunned, he's going to be absolutely fine.
I mean, maybe DC were like, well, we're going to run this safe lane when they were first picking up this hero, but they're like, well, now that he's not really getting countered or having any real issue in the laning phase, we could probably run him off lane, send Lone Druid in the mid lane, like you talked about for Weeha, and then pick up a safe laner for Resolution. Not that Resolution has done Faceless Void safe lane before, it's obviously something he's comfortable with, but it comes down to how confident do they feel for the move Faceless Void in the offlane. We'll wait and see if that's...
I'm sure they're fine with it, and they even do a lot of 1v1s as well, and give their offlane hero a Broodmother, for example, so... That's why it gets banned out by Void Boys. It would have kind of put their strat in a bit of a weird place. Bounty Hunter's okay against it, but at least in the laning stage, Void Boys would have been punished real hard. They opt with the Batrider, which is another one of the heroes they really like having. And right now, they have a pretty good four-man lineup while Lone Druid can safely farm and get things done. You know, Elder Titan plus Witch Doctor is really great together. Amps the magic damage, amps the physical damage, gives them some setup. Faces Void can do Chronos with Witch Doctor ulti. He can Chrono and set up Elder Titan ulti. There's just so many things that look good on DC's lineup, and putting a Batrider on top of that just looks good. I mean, they've got an Oracle. They're up against an Oracle. That's the one downside to their draft right now. But if that's the only list of problems, then they're looking like they're in a good spot.
Yeah, this Void Boy's last pick is going to have to kind of combine everything up to be a bit stronger here, because right now Digital Chaos looking pretty good. They'll go for the Alc themselves. So you have what I imagine to be a safe lane Slaughter and mid lane Alchemist coming out. And they're really, I think, banking on this Alc to get good farm purge. At least that's how I see it.
Their draft looks so much better now that it has Alchemist, though, because it synergizes with the Oracle, keeping him alive. They also have two sources of minus armor with Slaughter ult and Acid Spray, so I actually like that pick a lot. It's going to make Lone Druid a lot less versatile. Same with Faceless Void. If he has a lot more damage amp on him, then he can actually die with just one or two stuns, and Alchemist is going to give them another one of those.
Well, Weeha is going to be playing the mid Batrider, though, which is interesting. I'm not sure if you knew that going into the last pick as the last pick came out, but this is it's an interesting way that they're going to land this. Resolution, the Lone Druid move, playing the Faceless Void. I thought that the Batrider might be put in the offlane, and you put the Faceless Void in the safe lane and put Lone Druid mid, but it looks to be more standard than that. More standard, quote-unquote, I guess. It's still kind of interesting, but...
Yeah, I would agree. I wasn't necessarily expecting this either, but I don't think Batrider versus Alc is a very good idea, so... Lone Druid versus Alc wouldn't be very good. You wouldn't be able to pressure the Alchemist at all, whereas Batrider at least can threaten him a little bit, and you can counter-push the waves at an equal amount with Firefly, so at least he doesn't always get runes, stuff like that.
We'll have a quick pause here for both teams. 747 was late to getting into the game, and then of course he said he needed a moment as well. So Void Boys need to situate themselves in a good spot here, and with this draft I think they've done a good job. We were a bit concerned at the beginning stage of the draft. The Alchemist pick, though, has I think quelled your concerns.
Absolutely, it was basically exactly what they needed. Starts things off very well. Maybe not starts, but mid games off things very well. It's still going to come down a lot to the Slardar Blink Dagger because he's going to need to be the one to set up kills. But because he's in the safe lane, he should be able to get that at a reasonable timing. So if they can translate his Blink Dagger into kills on heroes, their game can be good. And Bounty Hunter as well can pressure. So it comes down to Bounty a lot, and then it comes down to the first couple rotations from Slardar. On DC's side, they're going to be more concerned with how good the ET roam is, or if it's effective at getting kills. Maybe Weehawk can get a kill here or there. And after that, you know, Blink on Bat, and eventually holding the game off until their Radiance timing on Lone Druid, which should come a little bit later than Alx. So I think it looks better for DC this game. Their late game especially is way better than Void Boys is, just because of Batrider.
Yeah, the Batrider, obviously. And not to mention the Faceless Sword, and like you mentioned, the Lone Druid later on to the game, obviously very strong. Good scaling supports, too. I think with the Bounty, with Track, all the different Void Boys can certainly help things out. And I'm not sure about... I don't really see Oracle in the late game that often, but I do like Witch Doctor late game. I also like Elder Titan late game, just because of the natural order.
Yeah, all their heroes are really good late game. They're pretty strong in the lanes as well, so that's why it looks a little scary for Void Boys here. They're going to have to fall back on Oracle late game, who really isn't that amazing unless you break Lasso and allows your Elk to survive a tank situation that you normally would die in. So, you know, it can be a bit iffy. Same with Bounty. He's a bit weak late game, or mid game even. Maybe you can itemize a bit different. Looks like Snaking's going to start in the jungle, and Bounty may go to the offlane.
Does he have an Iron Talon? Oh, he does. That item that we kind of everyone forgot about last game is back, Purge. It's everyone. He's got it. He's got that item. He's good to go.
But does DC have one?
I don't believe so. Mu doesn't, so.
Meanwhile, mid. Weird sucks item build on Elder Titan.
Yeah, he went Windlace first, then no other item, which I was like, okay, that's weird. Meanwhile, the Bounty almost dies mid to Weehaw's three static, or excuse me, sticking amp pop boys, which was not enjoyable. We'll see how things transition, though, as he does take some damage. He's actually gonna do it. So that's not a great start for a Bounty Hunter. He literally takes like 75% of his HP mid and then just denies himself to a neutral.
He had to. Like, if he uses all of his tangos to heal, then he's out of battle for like 40 seconds and then just use all of his tangos. Like, it absolutely would have been not worth it. So, this is better for him.
Weehaw constantly stacking up the sticky napalm, so much of that 747 is forced back to underneath the tower, but with wave pushing in, not that bad. Still only two last hits right now for 747, but with Grievous Greed, things a lot easier later on down the road.
He needs level 2 right now. He's got to drop acid spray to stay alive.
Yeah, and he finally has it. Ready to go with four sticky napalm stacks. Still might be in trouble. It's going to be pretty close. I think he's got 10 stick charges. He's got a salve as well. Can Weehaw find this kill? He needs one more, and he'll actually get it with the Firefly as well as the sticky napalm. Six stacks coming out, more than enough damage. That's your first blood going the way of the Batrider. It's rough for the Alchemist.
I think he misplayed that a little bit. I think he needed, as soon as he hit level 2, he needed to drop Acid Spray, but really the mistake was that he came up to get that last hit. But at that point, he was committed to the fight. He wasn't going to be able to escape Weehaw there. So, but once he did go for that last hit, he needed to drop Acid Spray ASAP, because those creeps needed to die as fast as possible, which would have gotten the tower hitting Weehaw instead of creeps. But they never got back onto Weehaw, and that meant that he was able to do whatever he wanted there.
Top lane, they did actually zone out Misery pretty effectively with this Bounty Hunter, who's starting to become a nuisance, although he did die early on by denying himself. Bounty Rune has been picked up for the Alchemist. Yes, that's what the Alk wants, is the Bounty Rune. Give him as many of those as possible.
Good body block by Misery there. He's possibly going to die either way.
Cask, he does get the Maledict off. He actually dusts up as well. And one more right click, Misery
will
fall.
What are these right clicks?
That's nuts.
Was that two super far right clicks to you,
too? Yeah, that was pretty not close in terms of range.
I mean, I don't know if that was like some weird server thing or what, but that was insane range. I couldn't believe that.
That shouldn't happen.
It must have been like a server difference or something, because that just looks so bizarre to me. Maybe he just needed... I thought he just needed to walk with him until he died, but he kept right-clicking. The first one, I was like, that was a mistake. And then the second one
the
hit?
The second one came out, yeah. It's like, all right, well. That's Dota 2.
Ooh, Sox in trouble.
Sox, Iron Shell Bounty Hunter. Let's see how far away these... What? Did you see that? That one was super far away. Did you see that one?
I wasn't completely focusing on that, but I think I sort of saw it.
That was nuts. He was literally like... He was like a brain sap and a half away from like actually being able to right-click him. It was kind of nuts.
A brain sap and
a half? Yeah, I don't know. I'm trying to use some sort of metric so that you can understand like... Like the range.
I have an idea. Mott, use units. All right, 747 in trouble mid.
Yeah, he actually is going to get caught with the Firefly. Five sticky napalm stacks. The acid spray. Good stick up, but it won't save his life. Tower will not bring down Weehaw, even with that acid spray on him. Won't be enough.
This is not good at all. Like, you can't die this many times to a Batrider. Like, Alchemist farms so much that he's getting extra gold every time he gets those kills.
Bottom. Mu's gonna find the kill, and Misery comes down, rotates, gets the Maledict up on Tatsul. Almost gets that kill as well. He'll stay alive. He's got a salve, though, so he should be okay.
I mean, this is not looking good for Void Boys. They're not stabilizing in their lanes at all. Bounty Hunter hasn't shown a mid yet once. That's tough, man.
Mu is now 22 CS bottom. We talked about actually Tatsul getting early with Blink Dagger. This is not going to help him. This is not a great start for them down bottom.
I mean, the lasso is going to come up so early as well, so him plus any other hero on DC's side is going to be able to get kills really fast in this game.
They have had a terrific start for Digital Chaos. They have two of the top net worth right now. It's a 1500 net worth advantage, and at least they kind of have the Alc to fall back on. The Darkseer's performing pretty well for snaking as well, but right now it's looking tough, certainly, for Void Boys at the beginning stages of this game.
And Void Boys keeps almost getting bear kills, too. This is the second one now that the bear's gotten away with almost no HP. The first one was due to good body blocking, but that one was just really close. It had like 7 HP when it got away.
It's a significant amount of gold going by the wayside, sadly. Yeah.
Could be like 600 over the course of the laning stage. That's like 2 or 3 kills.
Weah is gonna go for the drums build, and he has a couple of sacks in the jungle, which will help him secure some extra gold. No blink dagger yet, obviously, as he just picked up that item. And High Noon or Clairvoyance will maybe see Weah over here as he shadow walks yet again.
I think it's an okay time to go with the drum build. I mean, if blink didn't exist, Batriders would purchase a drum almost every single game, just because it gives you everything you need. Movement speed, gives you HP regen now, a little bit of everything stats. It's just really solid. The tankiness is not to be underestimated either. I mean, it's obviously worse at that now than it was before it got nerfed or changed, that is, but it's still decent survivability.
The drum, kind of interesting you say that if there's no blink dagger, maybe build drum every game. I guess that's true. I guess you're looking for movement speed. It's just, it's a good item early game for the rest of your team, too. It's not like that.
Honestly, it gives you everything you want. You want to be fast to get it to gap close, to pull people faster. Just blink is way better at that, just because it's instant, and people can't predict or necessarily stop it as soon as it happens.
Right. Well, top lane, Resolution has gone true, 4,000 gold. He's picked up a Gloves of Haste for his inevitable Midas. Down bottom, Chronosphere is up, Pat Souls taking some damage, not nearly enough, though, but here comes the lasso from Omega Poner, and there's Firefly on top, Pat Soul with 2 sticky napalms. He's gonna get blocked up, time lock, and then a boom, immediate time lock proc from Mu. Still has a salve, by the way. He doesn't really need it, he can just TP out if need be, he didn't have one, but still the Chronosphere, and then the inevitable dash comes up to get the kill, which was nice.
His skill build is basically, I can pressure you in lane, and that's what keeps happening. He's been getting kills here. It's hard against Oracle. Uh-oh. You can't really deal with Oracle, or with Void as Oracle.
Snaking actually gets out. Soxie didn't have enough mana for a stomp. They're looking for an entangle. Good surge away, and Sivil has to turn their attention as the dust is now up onto, Clairvoyance. Might try to deny himself. The Maledict will get off, and he's going to try to... Oh, the shockwave! You've got to be joking. He doesn't try for the deny. Gets it anyways.
Well, he's dead at least. He wasn't going to die otherwise, I don't think. He would have made it away, so that's okay for DC there. I think they're just happy he's dead.
Does Mu have a full Vlad's coming out? No, not yet. It's getting there, though. You need the, I think, Morbid Mask, then he's got it. He does, however, have an infused raindrop. Important item.
Vlad's is so good on DC this game because of all the minus armor. It's going to be great. Oh, Mu might die here. Probably not,
Fortune's
but maybe.
End. Time walks away as the Fortune comes through. They have a Slytherin Crush ready in 2. They get the Shuriken off the Iron Shell, and he's probably dead, yeah.
Yeah, if he was less greedy about his skill build, he would have lived there, but with only 2 in Time Walk, he was pretty screwed there. Nice little rotation. They do get a kill. That gives Slaughter 6 as well. Something's finally going okay for Void Boys.
Yeah, and he's building into Armlet. He's not going that way, Blink Dagger, which I don't know how you feel about. I mean, I think like the Armlet is fine one way or the other, but you seem to mention the early Blink Dagger a few times, and I want to know your thoughts on it.
I sort of thought it would be Blink, but I mean, if he blinks in, what's their follow-up? It doesn't really give them that much, so I guess going Armlet first to guarantee that at least you can right-click and do damage is pretty important as well.
That's fair.
And if he blinks in and gets chronoed or something like that, or goes stomped by Elder Titan, then he just dies for nothing. It's kind of really dangerous, actually.
Yeah. Double armlet, 1 for 747, 1 for the Slardar, played by Petzl down in the bottom lane. So they're going to have 2 of those relatively soon, especially with the Alc being able to farm his relatively quickly, with Grievous Greed now maxed out. And he actually is just the Gloves of Haste away from getting said armlet. He boots Sol Ring. He's now top in net worth. Moog gets the kill bottom on Omega Poner. Not sure if they just used last. It looks like it was last. Yeah. No Chronosphere needed. Easy kill.
That's Oracle, man. Like, he just isn't. He does damage in lane, but against Faceless Void, he's not a very good solution. He doesn't have a stun. If he's the one that gets initiated on, he's a weak hero as well, and he just keeps getting killed.
Entangle? No. Cass comes out onto Clairvoyance, who's chasing Misery down with the Iron Shell. Voodoo Restoration, not enough. Savage Roar will come through and actually keeps him alive, and Bad Soul was looking for that Slithering Crush. They needed to get them before they got to that corner, where they turn that corner, they get behind their Tier 1 tower. However, Clarus, it's right underneath the Sentry Ward. Shadow Walk said is looking for Misery still. Snake King looking for an Iron Shell. No vacuum up. He's only level 7 at this point. Resolution now. He's trying to get out of here as best as he can. The cast come through. There's the Shuriken. Misery will end up falling, but a nice cast nonetheless. Snakey gets entangled, but he's able to get out. The Flame Breaks to push him back in. Not enough damage to bring him down, however. Nobody dead just yet on the Radiant side. They get the stomp off on at least Clairvoyance. He looks like he'll survive, but now they're still looking for Weeha to find anything. No Flame Break back. They miss up with the Slithering Crush. Resolution. I'm not going to chase any further. Weeha gets one more Sicken Apum, but here comes the Fortune Zen. We'll do some damage onto him, but that's it. As they continue to split push bottom with Moo. So it's a one for nothing exchange. Yes, the bounty still is alive, but it's about to fall. Stomp! And there it is. Sox have chased him for about a minute, and they finally get to that kill. He even finds a bounty room for himself, and here comes the Alchemist. They really want Sox. They have the Amplified damage up. Slithering Crush is ready to go. And that's it. They won't die for him. They might have gotten that kill with Amp damage up in Slithering, as well as a couple of right clicks, but they break off pursuit. They won't go for it.
Yeah, or if he had one level of unstable concoction. Pretty standard how most Alks play. They just go mid and they
time
disregard their stun.
There's the Chronosphere. There's the Death Ward. No, he put it inside the freaking Chrono. They still should find this kill with Maledic up and cast bouncing through. The damage is enough and move. Time walking one. He can't get out in time. Still, even if they lose Misery, it might not be that bad of a trade, all things considered. Well, they did get both those kills to Pat Soul, so maybe it is a little bad, but they did bring down the Alchemist for DC.
Yeah, Misery a little worried to go into melee range there, but I think he could have kept Void alive. He's very close to getting a time walk off. May have sacrificed his life to do that, but... By the way, they trade 2-for-1. This is pretty okay for DC, especially because it's Alk. He's the high farmer. You're going to get a lot of gold for that kill.
If it wasn't the Alk, I'd say, okay, well, I don't know about that kill, but... And it's just unfortunate. Misery just drops the Death Ward down in Chronosphere, but what are you gonna do? They still found the kill anyways. Could argue if they killed him quicker, they might be able to get out faster.
Maybe. It was probably just camera position. He probably thought it was outside the Chrono, but he was probably camera to the right or something.
Isometric camera view or something or other.
Exactly. Vlad's is up on Void now, though, so very difficult to kill. More armor for him, more armor for his allies as well. That's a lot for Witch Doctor in the early game, actually, when he's only got 2 armor normally.
Yep. He needs any armor that he can get. Resolution will find Claire, or rather vice versa, as they finally bring the bear down, this time with the Shuriken getting it. 300 gold going Claire's way, and Resolution is getting chased down. There's the Entangle, though. He does have Shadow Walk. He actually doesn't have mana for it, but luckily he's pretty speedy with Track Up. Banks will keep him alive. Ashrook coming in. Snake King is going to get scattered by that from Soxa. He's Boots as well as Windlace to move him. He's got his level 6 Astral Earth Floater up and ready in one point in the natural order. And they'll start putting pressure. They've been putting pressure on the Tier 1 Tower top a lot. And they should end up bringing it down here. They're applying more pressure elsewhere for DC.
Looks like they're trying to get a kill bot.
No blink yet for Weeha, but this is still a last or it should be. But good Slithering Crush actually stops from happening. He sprints himself away.
That's a good try. It's a little hard to get that kill.
Weeha's gonna have his Blink Dagger now anyway, so that shouldn't happen again. Dust goes, connects onto the Bounty Dancer, but Stomp was already used, and unless Resolution really wants to commit to a chase, that's not gonna happen. They did take out that ward with the Sentry right nearby that was circled. So that's good. And back to mid we go. The Alk is, like you said, farming his Radiance faster than, of course, the Resolution will. 3,000 gold.
He's definitely behind, though. Normally, if Alk's doing quite well, like having a good game, he'll have Radiance around this timing, 13 to 14 minutes. So he doesn't yet have his Relic, he's catching up, but he's definitely behind. A little behind, like 1-2,000 gold.
Weeha's blinking into this is aggressive. There's a lot of heroes here. Moo is going to be tracked up, and they should see everybody. Moo knows he's getting chased. We'll at least get Fortune's End. But Unstable Concoction did stun 747. He had the the Chemical Rage going, so he was going to regen. But now all five heroes mid for DC. They want the Sirwin Tower, and they're not screwing around. And now with the new Minted Blink Dagger, they should find a last target. It is going to be, in fact, Whoever Wins. He did almost dodge said lasso, but not quite able to do so, and will actually be down for 30 seconds now.
That sort of guarantees they get the tower. I mean, it's only a bounty, but that's vision, that's extra gold if they go even on a fight. So tower falls and DC continues their strategy, which is just get a kill and take a tower.
It's that solid playstyle of Dota, and they've even found 747, although to chase him down, they probably need lasso. They won't go for the kill, not yet anyways. Misery's coming up. There's a smoke. He thought about running in over there. He's no wards or anything, so Misery just running in to try to find any sort of damage and aggression. They're thinking about it. Moon, by the way, does have Chronosphere, but he's still back towards mid. And it's back to farming, like you said, and Resolution actually up to 3,300 gold now, almost getting his Relic, and he's actually almost on pace with the Alk's Relic.
But Elk has a whole armlet on top of that.
Right,
so.
True. Yeah.
Obviously, there's a Hand of Midas as well, giving Ripper some offset, but it's definitely going to be pretty scary for a while. It all comes down to whether or not Oracle can keep him alive in these team fights.
That's the problem. Natural order scaling up, it's going to be harder
They're
and harder
for
later
top
game.
Fight.
This is going to be Soxa and Resolution versus pretty much all five, except for Alchemist, who's not farming. Sox has been scouted, but so has Resolution. They're looking for a stop. They find it on a 2, the TP away. Snakey finds the back. I think he wanted the back on Resolution instead, but they get off a great Savage Roar. 47, the Earthquake is going to come out. Flame Break back. Bihaz looking to fight this. Lasso, probably going to find Clairvoyance. They don't even need it. Good False Promise. They found Omega Boner with Lasso. They even get off the Entangle Hill Fall. Looks like actually Bounty Hunter should stay alive here. Blink forward. Chrono on to 2. Moose showing off his new Blink Dagger. Can they find it? The cast coming up. Misery. He's got Death Ward. They pop the back down and run the wall down. Snakey will fall in the end, though. And, well, at least he should. Maybe not. Shuriken actually stops for the Flame Break. Firefly's not there. Sticking 8 Bomb. 2 right clicks should do the job, and it will for Weeha. In the end, now up to the north. Claire is still alive. The good Shuriken coming through, actually stopping a lot of that damage coming in, but. Not
and the wall of replica really stopped a lot of the Witch Doctor damage.
Oh, he's so low. And they get the Entangle, Entangle coming out from Resolution. And the Spirit Bear keeps Weeha alive. Ugh, gosh, unfortunate.
And they'll turn it into a tower as well. Really nicely done by Moo, though. He was able to catch up and continue the fight, where otherwise it just would have been Oracle dying.
We just stole that bounty right from underneath the Slaughter's nose and then just fireflied up to the high ground.
Nice of him. Wait, who stole it?
We did. He was sitting at like 25 HP or like some ridiculous number.
He would have gotten so much gold. That's like a 600 gold swing or something like that. Maybe not that much, but like minimum 450-ish. That's so much gold to steal a bounty from Elk.
Yeah.
He does have Radiance at least, so he's not super upset about that, but, you know, that's a delayed boot to travel, tanky item kind of a thing.
Resolution's also about to have Radiance as soon as he finishes off this creep camp. And maybe the next creep camp. No, he's got it now. He's there. That's a frightening timing, 16 minutes into the game. Obviously, he did have the Midas, but he's really, like I said, like you said, he does have the arm over the Midas on top of the output. Like, that's still, like, he's keeping pace, I think, for the most part, with Resolution, which is very good for a lone druid in this game.
It normally kind of blows you out of the water. This game, though, are there any good Ags targets? Not that much, actually. Maybe Oracle Darkseer is it, actually, so I guess they're just playing it. There's not really like a super, super late game wind claws here.
There's the lasso. They find 747, but the False Promise comes out, and he's going to pop his Unstable Concoction. Still gets stunned up. Now there's going to be vacuum back in. Unstable Concoction only hit for the one. There's a stop. And of course, they have the Entangle on top of the Death Ward. Too much damage. The Earthsplitter doesn't even hit, and it doesn't need to. Blinking Crush, nicely done, but they get up a great Chrono onto 2. Staking as well as Claire. Push back in. That gets off in time. There's the cast coming through. Claire will fall first. Looking to find the second is going to be Staking. Firefly not up for Weeha. Already used. Now they set top of Staking. And now here comes Rezo. The bear gets the double kill. About to find a triple for himself. Looking for that Entangle proc. Can he get it? The bear is not fast enough and it's just not going to be there in time. 5 sticky napalms. They get off the Flame Break. Almost bringing him down. And he will fall to that nuke damage from the Bat Rider. Weeha gets an unstoppable spree. They've got now the Tier 2 tower in their grasp. Did buy back on somebody, I believe. It was, in fact, the Darkseer. That's a full 5-team man wipe coming out in DC. Oh, God.
There's a lot of advantage, man. Alk died so fast in that little engagement there. The Death Ward damage plus extra is just incredible.
Well, PC are, they're starting to chug along here, as the DC train is wont to do, as they now have a 7,500 net worth advantage, and they'll push into the Roshan pit.
I'm not even 100% that Elkhead is armlet activated, might have kept him alive, a little bit of extra armor there, but he was probably dead either way. Just really good spell casting by DC, despite the start of the fight going bad. And now they've got to play against a Batrider that's 6-0-7. Insanely farmed, he's got all the items he needs, with the exception of maybe like a BKB. He's having an amazing game.
Well, they're gonna see Bouncy here momentarily. He's just gonna walk up towards the pit. They get off the blink blast zone. She's on the edge of the sentry. Good false promise though, but they need some detection now. I don't think they have any. Shuriken comes out and they have a sentry ready to go. Slytherin Crush comes in. They're looking inside the pit, looking to try to fight this. Now, backside, Pat's ult, load and Firefly entangled up again. He'll fall. Next in line is going to be that dump. Bounty Hunter. He will go down to, again, that Firefly getting a double kill with a monster kill spree going his way. Lasso now down. He already used it already, of course, to start things off in the engagement. Chrono comes down on the other side. Death Ward again for Misery inside Chrono Spear, and then he canceled it. He canceled the Death Ward. Meanwhile, on the other side of the fight, they finally should bring Death Sneaking. Not able to do so. Omega Porter is going to get into the base as well. Three sticky napalm charges. He's just too slow to turn around. Vacuum back is there. 747 finally TPing home. And Resolution will try to TP out. Unstable Concoction being charged. It's about to be thrown, but luckily he'll make it away. And that Unstable Concoction should fly halfway across the map to hit him. I don't see it yet, but it's coming. There it is. And boom.
That little guy's got a good arm, man.
Yeah, he does. It's a quarterback.
So they get a gimme kill for almost nothing. Basically, 747 killed the Witch Doctor, like you said, because he canceled his Death Ward. But still not looking good for Void Boys. They're not winning fights. They're not really getting close to winning fights. Maybe they can win a fight like they did in the last game, where it looks like against all odds. But Yasha now coming for 747. As bringing his magic stick back, or maybe buying a new one, not quite sure. But he's just not as tanky. Normally, Alks rapidly go from this Radiance into tanky aspect, but he just hasn't been transitioning yet. He's just dying pretty fast. It's Elder Titan aura, you know? It's some other issues as well.
Yeah. The Elder Titan natural order is certainly making him look a lot squishier than Alks wants to be. Omega Poner is going to get, at least a kill with the Purifying Flames onto the Elder Titan. The last to come back in, there's the cast into the F4. This time it won't be canceled. Bring him down instantly. They're going to blink further looking for Claire. Flame Break back, pushes him a slight bit towards Weehop. Firefly is up, time walk further, and blinks up and move. In about 2 seconds, looking for another potential bash. They'll get a Firefly instead. Time dilation. Blink not necessary for Mu. He finds a double kill, and he actually just KS's at both of those kills. He just gets the last right click off to find him. Going to provide him almost indefusible. His top is pushing in from Tatsul. He finally has had his blink for a while. He's got his arm out as well, but that's it. And they might just go for the tier 3 push now, but we'll wait and see if that's going to be the case.
Yeah, they probably should. I mean, they can't really defend super well. Bear's getting decently tanky in a moment. He's looking for a hood on his main hero, actually, which just makes a lot of sense. Pipe eventually. It's going to be almost impossible for them to kill Lone Druid. It's pretty much all comes down to the right-click burst.
Last hit, we'll find Snaking. Good to the ring. Crush down to 4, though. Vacuum in and the wall on top. Unstable Kasha, the acid spray's there. Still, they will only lose the Batrider out of all of that. The Earth Splitter comes through, and now DC will back up. Oh my god, they should have lost so much more out of that. Oh dear god.
Yeah, they should have lost like 4 heroes. But the great Echo Stomp from Soxa delays it a little bit. They knew they couldn't commit that kill just because they would have gotten stomped themselves. So, but that's what Void Boys needed, and it didn't cost them that much to do it. Really just vacuum wall, that's it. And a nice Elk stun, so that's got to be what DC fears for the rest of the game. Yeah. Great stun from Slaughter to set it up as well.
Misery will pop a drum charge as he's being chased down. Here comes Boo. Chronosphere is up. No Shadow Walk, and he gets the Death Ward on the outside of the pit, only to get set up a moment ago. And then, well, they do find Moo, or excuse me, Clear nonetheless. Tatsul getting chased down also by Moo, who has his time dilation up. And he finds the bash. First hit root. He's not quite there yet as the bear is a little out of range. Won't find the root, but the cast will come through. Sprints up. There's the entangle. Armlet's up. Savage Roar was used just in case. Just to make sure there's no Slytherin Crush. He's dead for 43, and now they will push bottom. Instead of that mid lane, 747 has to Manta out of an entangle coming through. His Resolution did find one yet again. His bear is relatively low, but they'll just head towards mid, it looks like, for now.
It's just tough to play Slaughter against lots of damage over time here, as it kills your blink and you don't quite get the chase off. Like, as soon as you get caught, you're slowed and chased until you die, is what keeps happening to Slaughter, and it really shows the weakness of the hero.
Weeha has an Aghanim Scepter, so that's a double lasso if he finds it.
That's like game winning. If you lasso those two heroes, there's no way they can win the fight.
But what's the range for double lasso? 400?
I'm not quite 400. Sure.
Yeah.
400? Oh, that's pretty huge, actually. That's like really huge. That you can like definitely get two heroes with that. And it gives you damage per second on the lasso as well. 100 damage, so basically like nice. 400 damage nuke.
Yeah, I mean, at this early in the game, that's, yeah, 400 damage is pretty nifty. I would take it. We'll time walk away from an unstable concoction to the face. Again, Alk is obviously top of the net worth, but he's not at that point where he's able to do enough in this game.
He needs an AC or a Shiva's or something for him to be really strong. Probably a Shiva's this game, I think. They did spot the smoke at least, one little thing going for them. And they tracked Faceless Void. We'll see if they try to play around this in any smart way. Yeah, Mu's gonna go an opposite way because he knows he's tracked, but we'll see if Void Boy's read into this.
I mean,
should be obvious.
Yeah, I don't know. This is like a next level mind game kind of play. They're not heading towards stop. They will now with a TP coming out from Snaking. He's gonna walk out, he's lassoed. Yeah, there it is, and then the stomp should follow up shortly thereafter. Snaking is gonna try to get out, he's gonna pop the mech and then get entangled and die. He's dead for 60 moves with no buyback, so. That's just, I don't really know if the whole smoke kind of bait thing really played into that. It's just he was looking to defend top, and he was unfortunately not in the right place at the right time. By the way, that
talk
about for resolution is done, by the way. I just wanted to point that out real quick.
Yeah, it's going to be hard for them to get those kind of combos off now with the barrier. Everybody's going to have 400 more HP.
Yep. Weeha still with no last for 20, just being aggressive, blowing up the creep wave with the Firefly. The glyph will come through. And both tier 3 towers mid as well as bottom now at half HP. Or top, excuse me, not bottom. And they'll go mid. They'll finish up the mid one instead. Force forward onto Claire. I don't know who that... I think that was... Who was that? Was that Weeha?
It was Weeha.
Yeah, that was really nice. He's looking for that last one. Couldn't find it, though. False promise. Yeah, he does stay alive, but albeit barely. And this bear might have to be recreated. It doesn't go to anybody for the... for Void, excuse me.
Just keep stealing that bear last hit.
Yeah, those creeps just unfortunately not getting them the 300 gold they'd like.
Well, Void Boys does have this window here. The bear isn't very survivable yet, and they're kind of just exploiting it. They keep killing
it. No Aegis either.
They're looking for lasso, though. There's no Orcult. I think they maybe even should have grabbed him there. I'm not 100%, but...
It's tough. DC are all tracked up. Almost all of them now, and they'll back together as a team.
Just safer. Like, they maybe could have killed him, but it would only been one lasso. There would have been backup. Could be, like, a vacuum wall into Slar Stun. It's dangerous.
With Aegis down, going down, and, of course, I'm not really having the waves all the way pushed in. Teams will back up, Void Boys will stay together as a squad and maybe wait for the next initiative. Okay, I hold that thought. I said maybe wait for the next Roshan, but no, they smoke up and they're looking to find a fight. Also smoking at the Void Boys, but this time, oh, the Radiant Scan. Gonna find at least, they know that at least one person is there and they're gonna back up now together as a team. Realizing that Void Boys are, or excuse me, that DC are smoked up.
Yeah, Oracle doesn't have ult for 10 seconds, so they don't want to get engaged on just yet.
Everyone is in Viz. There's no vision going either side. It's actually super funny. If you hit the F2 and the F3 button, it just looks really weird.
As soon as the smoke breaks on Void Boy, so they're going to go in. Here it comes.
Yeah, they see Omega Poner. Lasso comes out. They wanted to get on the 2 with the Aghanims, but what are you going to do? He's dead instantly, pretty much, in 41 seconds.
That's exactly who they want, and that's why they got the Aghs. They can only grab one.
Immediate smoke up, and I think that was scouted. I'm pretty sure they saw the end of the puff of smoke coming out from Weeha's perspective. Meanwhile, the Alk is creep cutting here. As he's going to do on this hero, what he's behind. By the way, DC have not taken Rakt yet, so with how bad this has been for Void Boys, by the way, they're down only 5,000 net worth. With how bad this has been for Void Boys, they are still in this game. And Patsil might even find a kill on Mu or the bear. That's gonna be the bear. Savage Roar, maybe. Yeah. Might actually be able to resummon it. No, the vacuum back is there, and Saking will try to chase it down. Acid Spray. They still can't kill this bear. That's insane.
Not a good bear gank. They need to combo Alk with it or something like that. Someone with some actual damage. Not that Alk's damage is super high, and he's also going for the Octarine build, so gonna be more of a farming hero here, which is probably not terrible considering it's one of the ways that they can possibly win this game.
Oh, he just needs to farm and split push like crazy, I think. The amount of damage he can pump out is great, but he definitely needs to be able to farm and take this game late.
Yeah, his damage is okay right now. I wouldn't say it's good. It's
I didn't mean to say that he can. That's not what I meant to say, but anyways.
Okay. He's yeah. basically just getting to his sixth slot. He'll grab maybe, yeah, looks like a Shiva's or an AC for his last item, and then starts buying Ags for people. But I don't know if that's going to make that much of a difference. I mean, for Darkseer, it's a pretty big change damage-wise if he gets a good vacuum wall. But
it's like 140% with the Ag Scepter at its max level, which is nice.
It could be huge. It's also going to give him ET Aura, so they might get bat here.
Leon, he's in trouble. He just forces up his... that Proto is going to lead into two at the very least. Daking's now on top. He's going to pop the mech. Earthsplitter will find at least one. Cast coming out. Patchel about to be the second. Good back.
Oh, he's on mana. On
top. Snake has now been entangled up. The Death Ward is here. And without the Batrider, they still blow up everyone. The Diffusal now upon the 747. He is tanky, but he's not going to be able to survive this gank. They get off another entangle. The Chemical Rage not able to heal him up. They know that Clairvoyance is behind them. They're looking for him. Mu was trying to find Zed Bounty through his Shadow Walk since then. There's no Dire Vision coming out. Mu doesn't have a gem. No sentries on the deck, but with four dead and no buyback available for the Alchemist, they will go straight down mid, and they will take this Rax and more than likely purge this game.
Yeah, the Batrider kill was huge, but a little bit of miscalculation on Snake King. He needed to wand before vacuum, because once he vacuumed, he didn't have enough mana for Wall of Replica. So any chance that they had of swinging that teamfight around the mid was just gone. I mean, if that wall was up and Alk was in that kind of a fight, maybe he can win. He can play around it, spawn illusions, get some damage out, maybe get the Elder Titan Aura. It could have done something, but they missed the combo. It looked great because it killed Bat, but it wasn't enough.
DC will back together knowing that, well, they lose their courier, which is unfortunate, but also when the Darkseer has respawned, the only one that hadn't respawned at that point was the Alchemist, so just smart play from DC to back together as a squad, knowing that they didn't have to push anything too quickly. Weehaw just bridged up the Aetherlands when he died there, so he could have gotten the last wall onto two, and that range would be increased pretty heavily. The Aetherlands,
I'm not sure if it increases the range of the second one as well or not.
Yeah, that's actually a good point. I don't know if that it shouldn't probably. Well,
yeah, I'm not sure. DC did play that fight so well though. It was basically the Chronosphere of Mu that guaranteed that fight was a win. It would have been a loss otherwise if he didn't grab the Oracle. Maybe we criticize the Oracle as well for getting caught in that. If you're Oracle, he's got an Aetherlands as well. He's got to sit really far back. They got the Batrider, but you have to get out afterwards. And his positioning, he got caught, and that means that they lose the fight because he can't save somebody.
Right. The Oracle has had a tough game. Omega Pruner not having the best performance on said hero.
I just think it's Oracle, honestly. Like, I don't blame the players that much. I just feel like the hero is limited in what it can do. It has good situations and uses, but a jack of all trades Oracle, I don't think so. I don't think it fits that well.
For maybe a vengeful spirit in this situation.
Maybe something like that could be better, yeah. Super sold on Venge right now as well, but plenty safer than Oracle as an opening pick.
Smoke is up from Snakey, and 747 will lead the way. Not Smoke, if he's just gonna run straight into the pit. As spray on the ground, Roche is not particularly low. Looks like they were kind of baiting this fight out for DC. They'll find the lasso onto the Bounty Hunter, bring him towards that pit, and actually onto the high ground. Firefly will probably kill him. The castle bounce through the stick will not save his life. He will end up burning to death. Now 747 bashed up and entangled an Earthsplitter. Good false promise. Back wall's there into a Slithering Crush, but it's just not enough damage. Not yet, anyway. Misery will get brought down. Forces down on top. Weehaw now is actually getting chased down, but still, Mu is bringing people down to the backside. Double kill. We'll find a triple more than likely. No, it's a double four resolution as the low druid brings down Patsol on that slaughter. 747 will be the last to fall as the Alchemist will inevitably get the triple kill for Mu. Gets the bash to end things. And that is it. A 2-0 advantage in this best of five for Digital Chaos.
Yeah, DC is just, they played really well. They stomped all of their lanes, basically. The only exception is maybe the offlane. They kind of slightly lost offlane. They were close to losing the offlane badly. And by offlane, I mean their safe lane. The Lone Druid Bear almost died a bunch of times. But if you look at the scoreboard, it didn't matter at all. Like, Lone Druid didn't die that game. Yeah, his bear died a couple times.